Breaking, U.S. Senate just issued brazen order to U.S. military, war with North Korea is imminent. With each new passing missile test and belligerent attitude from the deranged North Korean dictator Kim Jong-un, President Trump and other world leaders are preparing themselves for the inevitable. President Trump has done his best to quell the rising tensions coming from the lunatic in the East, but nothing has stopped his lust for war and carnage. Now, the United States Senate has issued a terrifying order that shows how close we are to war, and it may happen sooner than later. North Korea, as you know, is a communist country, and their only desire is to have world domination by any means possible. The lunatic leader, Kim Jong-un, and all that came before him have treated their people in the worst possible, killing them for no reason, and they live in squalor. Kim Jong-un and those in North Korea are so full of hate that they wish to destroy the United States and Western culture, since it stands for everything they do not have. Over the past several months, the threats from Kim Jong-un have been increasing, as well as their missile launches that are only becoming more frequent. In light of the ever-growing tensions, United States leaders are now stating that war is imminent and that American military families should get out of South Korea before it is too late. And, with approximately 28,500 U.S. troops stationed in the area, plus thousands of more family members, that is a warning that is not given lightly. Here is more from Fox News. Senator Lindsey Graham said Sunday that he believes it's time to start moving the families of American military personnel out of South Korea as North Korea pushes the U.S. closer to a military conflict. Graham, a member of the Senate Armed Services Committee, said he will also urge the Pentagon not to send any more dependents to South Korea. "It's crazy to send spouses and children to South Korea, given the provocation of North Korea. South Korea should be an unaccompanied tour," the South Carolina Republican said on CBS Face the Nation. "So, I want them to stop sending dependents, and I think it's now time to start moving American dependents out of South Korea." About 28,500 U.S. troops are stationed in South Korea to deter potential aggression from the North. Last week, North Korea shattered 2.5 months of relative quiet by firing off an intercontinental ballistic missile that some observers say showed the reclusive country's ability to strike the U.S. East Coast. It was North Korea's most powerful weapons test yet. The launch was a message of defiance to President Donald Trump's administration, which a week earlier had restored North Korea to a U.S. list of terror sponsors. It also hurt nascent diplomatic efforts and raised fears of a preemptive U.S. strike. Threats traded by Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un have further stoked fears of war. Graham expressed confidence in the Trump administration's ability to manage the growing conflict with North Korea. "He's got the best national security team of anybody I have seen since I have been in Washington," said Graham, who has served in Congress since 1995. The Trump administration has vowed to deny North Korea the capability of striking the U.S. homeland with a nuclear-tipped missile. Denial means preemptive war as a last resort. "The preemption is becoming more likely as their technology matures," Graham told CBS. "I think we're really running out of time. The Chinese are trying, but ineffectively. If there's an underground nuclear test, then you need to get ready for a very serious response by the United States." Trump has said he spoke with Chinese President Xi Jinping about Pyongyang's provocative actions, and he vowed that additional major sanctions will be imposed on North Korea. China is North Korea's only significant ally, but it has grown increasingly frustrated over the North's nuclear and missile tests that have brought a threat of war and chaos to China's northeastern border. The left has created this monster by appeasing Kim Jong-un and others like him around the world so much so that Jong-un thinks he can get away with this insane behavior. Now, while in the past these sorts of actions would have caused Obama to go in and give Jong-un what he wanted, all in the name of diplomacy, but thankfully, those days are over. "If Kim Jong-un wants war, then we will be ready. The time of bending over and allowing terrorists to call the shots is over, and with President Trump at the helm, you can be sure our country will be the victor. Victor."